Hi, thank you for using My Court Coach. I'm Jaylen and I'm going to be your instructor as we talk about form DV-200, Proof of Personal Service. So this form is required when you serve the other party with your request for domestic violence restraining order. That whole entire packet has to be served on the other party. Anything that you want the court to see has to be served on the other party. Now, if you have the sheriffs serve all of the documents on your behalf, which can be done for free, then they will take care of completing this form and actually mailing it directly to the courthouse. So you don't have to worry about anything. However, you should call the sheriff at least a day or two before your hearing to check the status as to whether they actually did mail the proof of service and whether you could also obtain a copy, whether you could go directly to the sheriff's office to obtain a copy, or they can mail one to you so it gets in time before the hearing. Because what we don't want to happen is you go to your hearing and the other party doesn't show up and the court doesn't have this proof of personal service, and the court then has to reschedule you to come back, and then potentially that other party might show up to that hearing. But if you had the proof of personal service at your first hearing and the other party didn't show up, then essentially everything that you requested in your domestic violence restraining order packet would be granted. So with that being said, you could also have somebody over the age of 18, and that's not a protected party and is not associated with your case whatsoever, to also serve the other party, to also personally deliver these documents to the other party. And if you hire somebody to do it, then same thing. They would need to fill out this form properly so that the court can deem that service has been completed and that the court can move on at your restraining order hearing. So they can either issue orders that day if the other party is not present. And if they are present, you don't have this proof of personal service. Essentially, their appearance in the case without the proof of personal service suffices. Now, name of party asking for protection, that is you. Name of party to be restrained, that is the other party that you're asking the restraining order to be against. And then it notifies the server, so whoever is completing this, they have to be at least 18 years of age. And they can't be listed as a protected party on the request for domestic violence restraining order. Now you have to give a copy of all the documents. You cannot send them by mail, so it has to be personal service, and then complete and sign the form and give it to the person in one, so to give it back to you. Or you can have them go to the courthouse and file it on your behalf, but make sure that you have a copy. Very important that you have a copy of the proof of personal service, a signed proof of personal service. So the other party, or the server, has to give the other party the following documents: the DV-109 with the DV-100 and a blank DV-120. And it identifies what those forms actually are. So the notice of court hearing, the request for the domestic violence restraining order, a blank response to request for domestic violence restraining order. That blank response is very important because the other party needs to be able to know how to respond and what forms they can use to respond if they so choose. Then you, of course, need the DV-110 so that they are notified of the temporary restraining order and what actually was granted, the DV-105 and the DV-140. So if you two have children together, then the request for the child custody and visitation order and then the actual child custody and visitation order. And the request will be attached to the request for the DVRO, the domestic violence restraining order, and then the child custody and visitation order will already be attached to your temporary restraining order. And then if you completed an income and expense declaration or a financial statement, you would also check off those boxes. If you are requesting to continue the hearing, maybe you appeared at your restraining order hearing and you're requested to come back at a later time to give you more time to serve the other party, and you completed a DV-115 and request to continue hearing, then you would also make sure that that is part of the service packet. an order on a request to continue the hearing. Again, that would also be part of the request to continue hearing packet, and you would need to attach that to the request for the domestic violence restraining order packet. And if you went to your restraining order after hearing and the court is requiring you to personally serve the restraining order after hearing, what the court actually ordered at your time of your hearing, whether the other party appeared or not, and for whatever reason they're having you personally serve the other party, then you do need to fill out this form and check off this box. Typically, however, when you have the restraining order after hearing, or restraining order hearing generally, after the temporary has been granted, if the other party appears, no further service is necessary and you can just go ahead and mail the document to the other party. But if they were not present at the hearing, then the court can require you to personally serve that restraining order after hearing or have, again, the sheriffs do it on your behalf. And then the person that's filling out this form also has to certify that they gave the documents checked above, and they have to sign for when they gave the document, the time for which they gave the document, at what address, the city, state, and zip. So that's very important because that allows the court to know exactly when service was completed. I wanted to go back to, 4I back here because it says other, and other can be documents that you've attached to your request for order hearing, request for domestic violence restraining order. So if you have text messages or videos, anything that you really want the court to see and you had those prepared, then you can include that information right on this line to ensure that the court knows that you did give your evidence or any declarations, any witness statements, whatever it might be, anything that you want the court to see, that you did give it to the other party. Now, jumping to 6, the person that's filling out this form, so if it has to be somebody over the age of 18 and not a party to this action or a protected party whatsoever, they have to include their name, they must include their address, their city, state, and zip, and their telephone number. And then if they're a registered process server, they'll know to complete the county of registration, the registration number. So you need to make sure that whoever is completing this form or is doing the service on your behalf, doing the personal service, personally delivering the documents, that they are comfortable providing their name, their address, and their contact information. And the purpose of this is if anything went wrong with, like, let's say the other party is claiming that they didn't receive the documents, they actually didn't see this person on this date and time and address, then that person, the server, might actually have to go to court and testify in person that everything that is written in here is true and correct. So if you think that's actually going to be a problem in your case because you just believe the other party is going to lie about everything, make sure you bring your process server then with you to the hearing. And this is exceptionally true if this process server is a friend or a family member or someone along those lines. This probably would become an issue with the other party, but if it's a sheriff, unlikely. If it's a registered process server, also the chances are slim that this would become an issue with the other party. But you know the other party best, hence why you are filing the domestic violence restraining order, hence why you have a temporary restraining order. And actually, if you don't have a temporary restraining order, you still need to personally serve the request for the domestic violence restraining order and all of these forms. And the temporary restraining order would just have all of the denials in it, and you can still proceed with your restraining order hearing, but the service procedure is still the same whether it's granted or denied. We believe that if it is granted, however, that the sheriffs will in fact serve it, but if it is denied, then there is a service fee associated with it. I hope that you find this helpful. Best of luck.